In this illustration, we intend to simulate the stress within the soil due to the rectangular load in the Abaqus software. In this example, a rectangular load of 10 kPa is to be applied to the soil, and we are going to calculate the increase of stress having been caused within the soil. In the right picture, the diagram of stress having been created within the soil is drawn for different depths. Actually, we intend to simulate the example 3.10 from Sam Helwani book in the Abaqus software and compare the results gained from the Abaqus software with the Buzinesque solution. In this picture, you can observe the geometric shape of soil and the area where loading has been taken place. Well, I'll enter the Abaqus software for simulation. I'll click on create part. Here I intend to create the geometric shape of soil. I'll select the modeling space as three-dimensional, then select deformable and solid and continue. Here you can observe a geometric shape of soil. Its length is 100 meters, its width is 100 meters too, and it's 50 meters high. The loading area is also a rectangle with a length of 4 meters and width of 2 meters. Regarding that the geometric shape of soil is symmetric, here we will model only a quarter of the soil. That is 50 meters long, 50 meters wide, and has a height of 50 meters as well. I'll draw a square, enter its length as 50 meters and its width as 50 meters too. Done. Enter its height as 50 meters as well, and OK in this manner. I will enter property module, click on create material. Here I intend to define the properties of soil. I'll select elasticity and elastic from mechanical menu. The Young modulus of soil is 1 multiplied by 10 to the power of 7 kilopascal, 1 multiplied by 10 to the power of 10 pascal, and the Poisson ratio is equal to 0.3, and OK. I'll click on create section, select solid and homogeneous, continue, OK, then click on assign section, select the soil, done, and OK. I will enter assembly module, click on create instance. Here I'll tick on independent mesh on instance option, and OK. The loading area is a rectangle with a length of 4 meters and height of 2 meters, but since the model geometric shape is symmetric, we'll model only a quarter of that here. So we should create a rectangle with a length of 2 meters and width of 1 meter. To do so, I'll select datum from the tools menu, then select plane and offset from plane, select this plane, then flip and OK. I'll enter offset equal to 2 meters, then select this plane, enter value OK, and enter offset equal to 1 meter. In the next step, I'll select partition from the tools menu, then cell and use datum plane, select this plane, and click on Create Partition. In the next step, I select the whole of soil, done, select this plane and click on Create Partition. Here you can observe the loading area. In the next step, I select datum from the Tools menu, then select Offset from Plane, select this plane, enter value, flip, and OK, enter offset equal to 20 meters. Then I'll select Partition from the Tools menu, then use datum plane, select the whole of the soil, done, select this plane and click on Create Partition. In this manner. In the next step, I'll enter step module, click on create a step, select static general, continue. The analysis will be done in non-linear form. Enter initial increment size as 0.1 second and OK. I'll enter load module, click on create boundary condition. From here, select initial step, select symmetry, anti-symmetry, and continue. I will select this plane, and done. Actually, this plane is the plane of symmetry. So here, I'll select while symmetric, and OK. Again, I'll click on Create Boundary Condition, select Symmetry, Anti-Symmetry, and continue. I will select this plane. Done. As you observe in the picture, this plane is the plane of symmetry. So here I select X symmetric and OK. In the next step, I'll click on create boundary condition, select displacement rotation. I'll select this plane. Close the boundary condition of U1 for it and OK. I'll click on create boundary condition, select displacement rotation and continue. I'll select this plane, done. Close the boundary condition of U2 for it and OK. Again, I'll click on create boundary condition, select symmetry, anti-symmetry, and continue. I will select the bottom of the soil, done, close all boundary conditions of displacement for it, and OK. I'll click on create load. From here, select step 1, then select pressure and continue. As described in the book, a uniform pressure of 10 kilopascal will be applied to the rectangular area. I'll select this rectangular area. Done. And enter a pressure of 10,000 Pascal to it. I'll enter mesh module. Click on seed edge. Select these lines. Done. Consider the number of 10 elements follow them, and OK. Then I'll select these lines. Done. Consider 5 elements for them, and OK. In the next step, I will select these lines. Here I select single. Enter the number of elements equal to 30 and bias ratio as 10. I'll select these lines again. Done, and OK. In the next step, I select these lines. Done, enter the number of elements equal to 30 and bias ratio as 10, and OK. I'll select these lines. Done. Consider the number of 30 elements for them, and OK. Then I will select these lines. Done. Consider the number of 15 elements for them, and OK. Finally, I'll click on mesh part and yes. As you observe in the zone around rectangular loading, fine mesh has been used because there is stress concentration in the zone around this area. I will enter job module. Click on Create Job. Continue. OK. And click on Submit. The analysis was done successfully, so I'll click on Result. The purpose of this analysis is to draw this diagram. Actually, we intend to draw this diagram in the Abaqus software. To do so, I'll click on Tools menu, then Path, and Create, Continue, Add Before. First, I'll select this node, then this one, done, and OK. I'll click on Create XY Data, select Path, and Continue. From here, select Undeformed, tick on Include Intersections option. Here, I'll select the last frame, click on Field Output, select the vertical stress or the same as 3-3, and OK, and click on Plot. As you observe, the vertical stress was drawn for different depth. Here, the unit of stress is Pascal. But in this diagram drawn in the book, the unit of stress is kilopascal. Well, here we should convert the unit of stress from Pascal to kilopascal. To do so, I click on Create XY Data, then select Operate on XY Data, and Continue. From here, I'll select this diagram and divide that by 1000. In this manner, the unit of stress is converted from Pascal to kilopascal. I'll right-click on the diagram, edit. First, I will select the first column, copy and paste that in the Excel software. Then I will select this column, copy and paste that here. The first column is the vertical stress, the unit of which is kilopascal. The second column is depth, the unit of which is meter. Well, I will select these two columns. I'll click on this diagram from Insert menu. I'll double click on horizontal axis. I will enter minimum equal to negative 10. I'll tick on values in reverse order option. Then I'll click on vertical axis, enter its maximum equal to 20. Tick on values in reverse order option. As you observe, the results gained from the Abaqus software are quite conforming with those obtained from Sam Helvani book. The diagram drawn in blue color is the one obtained from the Abaqus software.